Good morning, students. My name is Ankit Dalela, Assistant Professor, Electronics and Communication Department, PVT University, Lucknow. We have been studying 8086 microprocessor in the subject microprocessor and interfacing. So we will cover the topics assembler directives now. An assembler directive is a statement to give direction to the assembler to perform the task of assembly process. The assembler directives control organization of the program and provide necessary information to the assembler to understand assembly language programs to generate machine codes. They indicate how an operand or a section of a program is to be processed by the assembler. An assembler supports directives to define data, to organize segments, to control procedures, to define macros, etc. An assembly language program consists of two types of statements, instructions and directives. The instructions are translated to machine codes by the assembler, whereas the directives are not translated to machine codes. The Microsoft Macro Assembler, MASM, is designed to select the assembler for one of Intel microprocessors. The programmer has to indicate the code to select the assembler for a particular microprocessor. If a program is preceded by the 486 directive, the assembler selects 80486 instruction set in the real mode. If the program is preceded by the 486P directive, the assembler selects 80486 protected mode instruction set. Similarly, directives for any other microprocessor is to be given in the beginning of the program. Directives for Pentium processors are 586 for a real mode instruction set and 586P for protected mode instruction set. In case the programmer does not give the option for a microprocessor, the assembler selects 8086 or 8088 instruction set by default. So we will use here some symbols, variables and constants. So let's see the symbols whose values can be varied while running a program is called variable. The names of variables should be meaningful to increase readability and to make program maintenance easy. Symbols consist of following characters, uppercase and lowercase alphabets, A to Z in uppercase and A to Z in lowercase, 0 to 9 numbers, special characters like dollar, question mark, at the rate, underscore, etc. Digit cannot be used as the first character of an assembler variable. Dollar and question mark are not used in a variable because they are used for other purposes in an assembly language programming. The variable must begin with an alphabet or an underscore. There is no distinction between an uppercase and a lowercase letter. The length of an assembler variable depends on the particular assembler. Most 8086 assemblers permit the use assembler variables and labels up to 32 characters. A numeric constant may be a binary, decimal or hexadecimal number. To differentiate between them, symbols B, D and H are used at the end of a binary, decimal and hexadecimal number respectively. A number without any identification symbol is taken as decimal number. Decimal and hexadecimal numbers are converted to their binary equivalent for processing. Hexadecimal number with its first number A to F must begin with a zero. Otherwise, it will be taken as a symbol. Now, to assign names to variables, constant and addresses, assembly language programs contain three general types of data: variables, constants and addresses. In an assembly language program, names can be assigned to variables, constant and addresses. This allows programmer to mention them by names rather than to remember or calculate their value each time the programmer refers to them in instructions. If the names are assigned to variables, constants, and addresses, the assembler uses these names to get the corresponding data items or address when the programmer refers to them in instructions. Assembler directives are used to assign names to variables and constants. Labels are used to give names to addresses. So you can see on the screen some alphabets: assume, DB, DD, DQ, DP, and DW. These are some commonly used assembler directives. We will explain them one by one. First is assume. The assume directive is used to inform the assembler the names of the logical segments which are to be assigned to the different segments used in an assembly language program. In an assembly language program, each segment is given a name by the programmer. For example, the code segment may be given the name code or code underscore SEG or my underscore code, etc. Data segment may be given the name data or my underscore data or data underscore segment, etc. The first is assume CS colon code. This tells the assembler that the logical segment named code contains the instruction statements for the program and should be treated as a code segment. The segment named code contains the machine codes of the instructions. The code segment register is to be loaded with the starting address of the code segment given by the operating system for the label code in the assembly language program. Next is assume DS colon data. This tells the assembler that for any instruction which refers to a data in the data segment, data will be found in the logical segment data. This directive informs the assembler that the name of the data segment is data. This is a user-defined segment name. It contains data of the program which is being executed. The DS register is to be loaded with the starting address of the data segment given by the operating system for the label data in the program. The move AX, square brackets BX instruction after the assume directive informs the assembler that the memory location given by square brackets BX is in the segment named data. An instruction move AX, speed after assume directive tells the assembler that the variable speed has been defined in the segment named data. Next is assume SS stack. This assume SS stack tells the assembler that the name of the stack segment used by the programmer is stack. This name is a user-defined name. It stores addresses and data of subroutines, saves the contents of a specified register or memory locations after push instruction, etc. The stack segment register SS holds the starting address of the stack segment allotted by the operating system. Next is assume ES colon extra. This assume ES colon extra informs the assembler that the name of the extra segment is extra, which is a user-defined segment name. In Intel 8086 microprocessor, string instructions may use DI register to point the destination memory address for data. The extra segment is used to hold the addresses pointed by DI. Now comes assume CS colon code, DS colon data, SS colon stack, ES colon extra. This all is used as a single assembler, and it gives the name of all segment used by the program. Next is DB. DB directive is used to declare a byte type variable or to store a byte in memory location. DB defines a byte type variable. In this statement, there may be single initial value or multiple initial values of the defined variable. If there is one initial value, one byte of memory space is reserved. If there are multiple values, one byte of memory space is reserved for each value. General format is name of the variable DB and then initial value or values. For example, price DB 49H, 98H, 29H. It declares an array of 3 bytes named as price and initialize. Next is name DB ABCDEF. It declares an array of 6 bytes and initialize with ASCII code for letters. Next is TEMP DB 100 DUP then question mark. Set 100 bytes of storage in memory and give it the name as TEMP, but leave the 100 bytes uninitialized. Program instructions will load values into these locations. Now velocity DB 0. It informs assembler to reserve 1 byte of memory space for the variable named velocity and initialize it with value 0. Weight DB 85. It informs assembler to reserve 1 byte of memory space for the variable named weight and initialize with value 85. Force DB question mark. It informs assembler to reserve 1 byte of memory space for the variable force. The question mark in the data definition informs assembler that the value of the variable is not known and hence it is not to be initialized. Next is array DB 5 DUP brackets 4 DUP 379. It informs assembler to reserve 30 bytes of memory space and the series 333379 is to be duplicated 5 times. Similarly, we have many examples of this. Next is DW. DW directive is used to define a variable of type word or to reserve storage location of type word in memory. It defines variable may have one or more initial values in the directive statement. If there is one value, 2 bytes of memory space are reserved. If there are multiple values, 2 bytes of memory space are reserved for each value. General format is name of variable DW, initial value or values. Example, multiplier DW437AH. This declares a variable of type word and name it as multiplier. This variable is initialized with the value 437AH when it is loaded into memory to run. Next, exp1DW 1234H, 3456H, 5678H. This declares an array of 3 words and initialized with specified values. Next, STOR1DW100DUP brackets 0 reserves an array of 100 words of memory and initializes all words with 0000. Array is named as STOR1. Next, some DW question mark. This informs assembler to reserve 2 bytes of consecutive memory locations for the variable named sum. The question mark in the directive statement tells assembler that its value is not known and hence it is not to be initialized. Next, data underscore array DW 5438, 6985, 7348, 3569. It informs assembler to reserve 8 bytes or 4 words of consecutive memory locations and initialize them with the values as specified in the above statement. Next, number DW 25. It informs the assembler to reserve 2 bytes or 1 word of consecutive memory locations for the variable named number. The first byte of the memory is to be initialized with the ASCII code of 2 and the second byte is to be initialized with the ASCII code of 5. Hence, the 2 bytes of memory space contain 3235H. Next is DD. DD means define double word. It defines a double word type variable. The defined variable may have one or more values in the statement. If there is only one value, 4 bytes of consecutive memory locations are reserved. If there are multiple values, 4 bytes of memory locations are reserved for each value. General format is number of variable, DD, initialized value or values. Example, number DD 23958634. This directive informs assembler to reserve 4 bytes or double word of memory locations for the variable named number and initialized with the number 23958634. Next is DQ, which is define quad word. This directive defines a quad word type variable, which is a variable which occupies 8 bytes of consecutive memory locations. The defined variable may have one or more values in the statement. If there is only one value, 8 bytes of consecutive memory locations are reserved. If there are multiple values, 8 bytes of memory space are reserved for each value. General format is name of variable, DQ, initialize value or values. Example, number DQ 15689348938467735. This directive informs assembler to reserve 8 bytes of consecutive memory locations for the variable named number and initialize with the above mentioned number. Other examples are similar to those given for DB and DW. Now comes DT, which is define 10 bytes. This directive defines a variable of 10 bytes. In the directive statement, there may be one or more values. If there is only one value, 10 bytes of consecutive memory locations are reserved. If there are multiple values, 10 consecutive memory locations are reserved for each value. General format for the statement is name of variable DT, initial value or values. Example, number DT 34968435876934839251. This directive informs assembler to reserve 10 bytes of consecutive memory locations for the variable named number and initialize with the above specified value. Next is end. It means end of program. End directive is placed after the last statement of a program to tell the assembler that this is the end of the program module. The assembler will ignore any statement after an end directive. Carriage return is required after the end directive. For example, end P. End P means end procedure. End P directive is used along with the name of the procedure to indicate the end of a procedure to the assembler. End P directive informs assembler the end of a procedure. In assembly language programming, subroutines are called procedures. A procedure may be an independent program module to give certain result or the required value to the calling program. A procedure is given a name, that is a label. The label is used as prefix with directive end P. This directive is used together with PROC directive to enclose a procedure. To specify the type of the procedure, the term FAR or NEAR is used after the PROC directive. The type FAR indicates that the procedure to be called is in some other segment of memory. Type NEAR indicates that the procedure is in the same segment of memory. If type is not specified, the assembler assumes it NEAR, which is near. The general format for NP directive is procedure name NP. Example, speed under control, speed underscore control, PROC FAR, which is the start of the procedure. Then comes the colon, which gives the procedure instructions. And at the last, speed underscore control NP, which is end of the procedure. Next is NM. NM is used to inform assembler that this is the end of the macro. The directive NM is used with the directive macro to enclose macro instructions. Example, complement macro, start of macro, colon, macro instructions, then NM, end of macro. Complement is the name of a macro. The name is given before the directive macro, which tells the assembler the beginning of a macro. Next is NS, which is end of segment. The NS directive informs assembler that this is the end of a segment. The name of a segment is given using assume directive, which has already been explained. The name of the segment is used as the prefix of the NS directive. Its general format is segment name NS. For example, code segment. Here it starts the logic segment containing code, then some instruction statements to perform the logical operation, and then code NS, which is end of segment named as code. Next is EQU, which is equate. This EQU directive is used to give a name to some value or to a symbol. Each time the assembler finds the name in the program, it will replace the name with the value or symbol you give to that name. If any value or symbol is used many times in an assembly language program, a name is given to the value or symbol to make programming easy and simpler. Each time the assembler finds the given name in the program, it replaces the name with the value or symbol which has already been equated with that name. The general format for the EQU directive is value name EQU value or symbol name or symbol. Example, factor EQU03H, you have to write this statement at the starting of your program, and later in the program you can use this as follows: add AL comma factor. When it codes this instruction, the assembler will code it as add AL03H. The advantage of using EQU in this manner is, if factor is used many number of times in the program and you want to change the value, all you had to do is change the EQU statement at beginning. It will change the rest of all. Next example is room underscore temperature EQU02H. This directive tells assembler to replace room temperature by 02H. If EQU directive is written in the beginning of a program and later on move AL comma room underscore TEMP is written in the program, the assembler will treat this instruction as if it were move AL02H while giving its machine codes. Next is even, which means align on even memory address. This even directive instructs the assembler to increment the location of the counter to the next even address if it is not already in the even address. If the word is at even address, 8086 can read a memory in one bus cycle. If the word starts at an odd address, the 8086 will take two bus cycles to get the data. A series of words can be read much more quickly if they are at even address. When even is used, the location counter will simply be incremented to next address, and NOP or no operation instruction is inserted in that incremented location. This directive informs assembler to increment the content of the location counter to the next memory address if it is already not at an even address. The content of the location counter holds the address of memory location assigned to an instruction or variable or constant. The even directive can be used in both code and data segments. When it is used in a data segment, the location counter is simply incremented to even memory address if it is already not on an even address. When it is used in a code segment, the location counter is incremented to the next even memory address if it is already not on an even address. A NOP instruction is inserted in the memory location which falls vacant due to such increment in the code segment. The 8086 microprocessor takes one bus cycle to read a word from an even memory address, but it takes 2 bus cycles to read a word from an odd memory address. Therefore, a series of consecutive memory words can be read much more quickly if they are at an even memory address. Example, data 1 segment, location counter will point to 0009 after assembler reads next statements. Sales DB9 DUP question mark declares an array of 9 bytes. Even increment location counter to 000AH. Record DW100 DUP0, which means array of 100 words will start from an even address for quicker read. And then data 1 ends. The use of even in this example makes the variable to start at even memory address. Thus, the total read time is much less. Next is EXTRN, which is external. This directive informs assembler that the names, procedures, and labels following this directive have already been defined in some other program modules. The names, procedure, and labels declared and as external in one program module must be declared public using PUBLIC directive in the program module in which they have been defined. When the programmer informs assembler that the declared item is an external one, the assembler puts this information in the object code file so that the linker can connect the concerned two program modules together. The general format for EXTRN directive is EXTRN variable name type of variable, EXTRN procedure name near oblique far. For external named variable, procedure or constant, its type is to be specified. Example, EXTRN multiplier colon word. In this directive, the variable named multiplier is an external variable and it is a word type variable. Next is EXTRN correction underscore factor colon ABS. In this directive, correction underscore factor is an external constant. It has been defined with EQU directive in another program module. Constants are identified by type ABS. Next is EXTRN temperature underscore control colon FAR. In this directive, temperature underscore control is an external procedure. The term FAR indicates its type. EXTRN statement should also be accompanied by segment and NS directives. Take an example in which temperature underscore control procedure given in PRM program model number 1 is to be called in program model number 2. It has to be declared public in PRM 1 and EXTRN in PRM 2. Segment and NS directives will be used as in the other programs. Next is group, which means form a group of related segments. The group directive is used to group the logical segments named after the directive into one logical group segment. Directive group informs assembler to form a logical group of the segments named after this directive. The segments which are grouped into one logical group will have the same segment group base. The assembler tells linker or loader to link the segments of the group so that they lie physically within the same 64 KB memory segment. The general format for the group directive is group name, group segment names. Example, analysis group code data stack extra. In this directive, analysis is the name of a group of segments and code, data, stack, and extra are the names which have been grouped together. Now in assume directive, the name of the group can be used as assume CS colon analysis comma DS colon analysis comma SS comma colon analysis comma ES colon analysis. So next is global. In this directive can be used in place of public or EXTRN. In the program module where a name or symbol is defined, it can be declared public using global directive. Once an item, variable, constant, procedure, or label is declared global, public, it can be used in any other program module. For example, a variable is defined data segment multiplier DW1000 data in S. The variable multiplier can be declared public using global directive as follows: global multiplier. Now the variable multiplier can be used in any other program module, like global multiplier colon word. Next is include, which means include source code from file. This include directive is used to insert a block of source code from the name file to the current source module. Directive include informs assembler to insert a block of codes from a named file into the current program module. It is convenient to keep all data and frequently used macros in a file called header file or include file. The statements defined in the header file can be used in the current program module. The general format for the directive include is include file path specification. In the name of full file path is not mentioned, assembler uses current directory. Example include control.temp. In this directive, it informs assembler to include all statements mentioned in the current file control.temp from the current directory. Next is label. In an assembly language program, labels are used to give names to memory addresses. When assembler begins assembly process, it initializes a location counter to keep the track of memory locations, that is memory addresses. The content of location counter holds the address of a memory location assigned to an instruction during assembly process. The label directive is used to give a name to the current value in the location counter, that is the current memory address which is in the location counter. The type of the label is to be specified. When the label is used as the destination of a jump or a call instruction, its type is specified as far or near. When the label is used as a data item, its type is specified as byte, word, double word, etc. General format of the label directive is label, label name, and then label type. Next is length. It is an operator to find the number of elements in a data item, such as an array or a string. Variables are defined as data segment array DW 10 DUP question mark. Next is local. Local means when certain variables, constant procedures, or labels are to be used in only one program module, they are declared local using local directive. The same names or labels, etc., which have been declared local in one program module, can be used in another program module, declaring again them local in that program module. Thus, the same labels, etc., can be used in different program modules. Several variables can be declared local using single statement. Next is macro. A sequence of instructions to which a name is assigned is called a macro. The name of a macro is used in assembly language programming. Macros and subroutines are similar. Macros are used for short sequences of instructions, whereas subroutines for longer ones. Macros execute faster than subroutines. A subroutine requires call and RET instructions, whereas macros do not. Directive macro informs assembler the beginning of a macro. It follows name which is given to the macro. If there are any arguments, they are written after the directive macro. The macro directive is used with the NM directive to enclose a macro. General format of macro directive is macro name, macro, and then argument 1, 2, 3, and so on. Next is name. A large program may contain several name modules. Specific name can be given to each program module using name directive. For example, voltage underscore control may be the name of program module to control the generated voltage of an alternator or AC generator. There may be other similar program modules to control other operations of the alternator. All such program modules can be included in a program alternator underscore control to control an alternator in a power plant. Next is offset. It is an operator to find the offset or displacement of a variable or procedure with respect to the base of the segment which contains the named variable or procedure. The operator can be used to load a register with the offset of a variable. Using the given value of the offset, the variable can be accessed employing one of the indexed addressing mode. Next is ORG. ORG means originate. This directive directs assembler to set the location counter at memory address specified after the directive. When assembler begins assembly process, it uses the location counter to keep track of memory addresses allotted to statements of a program module. When assembler starts assembly process, the location counter is automatically set to zero. If ORG directive is used, the location counter is set to the memory address specified with ORG directive. For example, ORG 500H. Now comes PROC, which is procedure. The PROC directive is used to identify the start of a procedure. The term near or far is used to specify the type of the procedure. For example, smart PROC far, this identifies that the start of a procedure named as smart and instructs the assembler that the procedure is far. Smart NP, this PROC is used with NP to indicate the break of the procedure. Next is PTR. PTR operator is used to assign a specific type of a variable or to a label. Example, INCBX. This instruction will not know whether to increment the byte pointed to by BX or a word pointed to by BX. INC byte PTR square brackets BX increments the byte pointed to by BX. This PTR operator can also be used to override the declared type of variable. If you want to access the byte in an array, words DW437AH, 0B97H, MOV AL, byte PTR words. Next is public. The public directive is used to instruct the assembler that a specified name or label will be accessed from other modules. A large program usually consists of several program modules. The variables, constant procedures, and labels defined in program module may be used in some other program module. Therefore, such items are to be declared public using this directive in the program module in which they have been defined. The program modules in which they are to be used, they are declared external using extrn directive. Example, public divisor, comma dividend. These two variables are public, so these are available to all modules. If an instruction in a module refers to a variable in another assembly module, we can access that module by declaring as extrn directive. Now comes the type. Type operator is used to instruct the assembler to find the number type of variable and find the number of bytes specified to that variable. For example, byte type variable, assembler will give a value 1. Word type variable, assembler will give a value 2. Double word type variable, assembler will give a value 4. Add bx, type word underscore array. Here we want to increment bx to point to next word in an array of words. There are some more called a record. This directive defines the bit pattern within a byte or word. Its general format is record name, record field specification 1, 2, and so on. Next is segment. This directive indicates the beginning of a logical segment. The segment and end as directives are used to enclose a logical segment containing code or data. The general format of the segment directive is segment name, segment type, word or public. Next is SEG. It is an operator. It is used before a variable, procedure and label. It substitutes the base address of the logical segment in which these items lie. Next is short, SHORT. It is an operator. It informs assembler that only one byte for the displacement is required to code a jump instruction. The use of short operator before a jump instruction saves one byte of memory. Otherwise, the assembler will reserve 2 bytes for the displacement. Its general format is JMP short label. Next is size. It is an operator to find the number of bytes allocated to a data item. It differs from the length operator as the length operator finds the number of elements in a data item. Next is struct. This directive defines the beginning of a data structure. Within the named data structure, the data type, which is a collection of primary data types such as DB, DW, DD, etc., is declared. This type of data structure declaration allows programmer to define a variable which has more than one data type. And the last is, are there some DOS function calls, which are AH00H to terminate a program, AH01H to read the keyboard, AH02H to write a standard output device, AH08H to read a standard input without echo, AH09H displays a character string, AH0AH buffered keyboard input, INT21H call DOS function. So these were some of the assembler directives and DOS function calls. Thank you for now. We'll continue in the next lecture. Thank you.